Gala are members of an extraordinary community, one dedicated to Usdan's mission of exploration, discovery, collaboration, and presentation. We ask the faculty to set a standard of excellence at Usdan, one that will challenge each of us to strive for greater achievement every day. We do so as caring members of a campus family, one that celebrates creativity, embraces diversity, and champions opportunity. The board, faculty, and staff thank you for your support of these ideals with your presence at tonight's celebration of student achievement. For 36 years, I've been a member of a community that lives and works as an ensemble. It's been a privilege to be its conductor, as tens of thousands of students have inspired me to play a small part in assuring their happiness and success. At Usdan, this means supporting a wonderful staff, one that recruits great teachers and helps them to thrive. Each of these teachers is dedicated to creating community in the studios in order to assure student success and satisfaction as the young people find themselves in their pursuit of beauty. These teachers inspire children to explore without, as Suzanne Usdan said, fear of failure. And while we're proud of the exhibits, readings, concerts, and plays that are presented at Usdan, we treasure the reward of a journey as much as the satisfaction of the result. Just last week, the staff, members of staff, were dealing with a challenging issue here on the grounds. As we struggled to find a solution, one of our number said, let's take a break and see some kids at play. So we set off on our own journey of discovery. And guess what? We were reminded that at Usdan, work is our students' definition of play. It was evident in every painting studio that we visited, in every chess group when we went to the chess center, in every rehearsal, and in every maquette designed and crafted by our budding architects. And we were reminded of something else. The companion to Usdan play is Usdan joy, as the spirit of excellence is contagious. And here, we live the joy. The staff sees it as we greet children in the morning and say goodbye in the afternoon. We see joy in each child's search for insight, just as we also see it in their smiles of achievement. We see joy in the studio, at the daily concert, during the lunch periods, in the pools, and on the paths. Now there's an inspiring staff outing. A new conductor will soon have the privilege that I have had for so long. Lauren Grant Schloss will lead us to ever greater heights, and I will be her most ardent cheerleader. As Lauren steps onto the podium, I wish that I could thank each of the thousands of students, teachers, staff, and leaders who have enriched this community and who have inspired me at the same time. One was a violinist whose string needed to be replaced. One was a teacher anxious to share her students' awakening in art. One was a colleague whose wedding day we shared. One was a writer whose poem brought tears to my eyes. One was a donor who jumped at the chance to name this great theater for her husband. One was a child whose uncooperative ice cream wrapper I was able to open. One was a dear friend who triumphs in health over unimaginable odds to return here to share his art with adoring students in our concert band. One is my wife. Several are my